In this video, I'm going to show you how blogging with Wix is awesome and has multiple features that you can customize to complement your unique brand. Hey everyone, I am Marina Lotai from Yes to Tech, and I empower entrepreneurs and small business owners just like you create a website from scratch with no prior technical knowledge. Now, Wix is not usually the blogging platform of choice for many people. Usually, you choose something along the lines of WordPress or Blogger. But today, I'm going to show you why using Wix is amazing and can actually boost your website's SEO and traffic and make all of your blogging needs so much easier. So first of all, this here is my blog on Wix. And to add a blog on Wix, if you don't have one already, all you have to do is click this plus sign here, the add sign on the left-hand side panel, click on blog all the way at the bottom, and over here, there will be the option to add a new blog. Since I already have a blog, it's showing me the blog elements I can add to the blog. But if you don't have one, just click on what will be over here and boom, it will automatically feed into your website. Now, there are two different places where we can customize our blog. So if you go down to the pages menu and go to the blog section right here and click on the blog pages, you can either customize the blog itself or the single post. So let's start with the blog itself. If you click on the blog, you will see that this settings manual appears right over here. So if you click on settings, we can change the blog feed settings. So we can change the number of posts per page, the date format. There are various options here that you can choose from. What word precedes author. So I have this little bar over here. So if you see, you have July 25th, 2017, a little bar and my name. And we have options to customize the post text, so maximum characters, the read more button width and height, what the read more button says, and the pagination. So we can have different names. So next could be continue, or previous would be go back, whatever you prefer. Now we can also change the layouts. Maybe I don't like this layout anymore. I want to put this layout instead. Just click on it and see, it just feeds right in and changes absolutely everything. You can change the alignment from left to right or from right to left, change the post padding, the space between posts, the date alignment and the title alignment. I like to leave everything centralized. The post body, I change it to be on the right. The read more button, as you can see over here, it's also centralized, and the read more button text margin. So there are many, many things that you can change over here. And one of the funnest parts that we can change is the design. If you click here, there are the design elements of absolutely everything, the blog feed design. So say the title, let's design that. We can change the theme, the font. So it's a basic heading, we could change it to small heading or whatever else you want. We can change the font size, the color, highlight, if it's underlined, bold, etc. And we can do that for each of the blog elements. And this is on the main page. So when someone goes onto your website and clicks blog, this here is a section where we would change everything. So post body design, so change the theme, the font, the size, color, highlight, etc. The date and author, same thing. Categories, so this is the fun part. So here, the category, see, we can change the button color and appearance, and these are all customizable, so you don't have to have the same button for each. the read more button. So if you can see, it's a different design. My read more button design is different from my category button. It does not have to be the same. We can change the background so it can be something colorful or just something that's plain and white. Could make it black, whatever color you prefer. And the pagination, also here we can change the button. So this is the back and next buttons that we had talked about before. So this here you can play around with an absolutely each one. We can also stretch, make it full width or not. And one of the fun things in Wix is that if you need help, you don't know exactly what to do, just click this question mark and you have absolutely everything that you need right from the editor. Now, if we go to the blog pages and change the single post, here we are, we have the exact same options to customize a single post as we did with the blog pages itself. So here is the pages if we had gone to the blog and clicked on a particular post. So if you click on it again, you can also do the same thing with the settings. We can change the date format, the word that precedes the author. We can select the social buttons that we want at the bottom. So if someone wants to share it in Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Google+, like this post, and change the button size. We can change the selection share, or we can have the social counters, and we can even customize what the tags button says. So if you go all the way at the bottom, you'll see that there is a tags section here, tags. So this could be different words or categories or whatever you want to call it. And here are all the share buttons that I like inserted. We can also change the layout. We can change the alignment from left to right to right to left. Post padding, change the date alignment, the title alignment, and the alignment of the buttons. And here, if you click on design, it's basically the same thing as we had with the blog. You can change the design of the title, so the font, the theme, the size, color, etc. Same thing with date and author, the post body, categories. So here again, it's a button. Maybe you wanted a button there to be the simple one, but then on the single post pages, you want it to be this more flashy button, whatever you prefer. With the tags, you can also change the font, theme, color, and the background can also be different for single posts. And basically that's it. So you can change everything. And you can also edit this particular post by clicking there. It will always show you the most recent post and things that you can edit. See, it just took us directly to that post. Or you can click on manage posts and it will show you all of the posts that you have and you can edit each one of them individually. So this is right from the editor. So here we are right from the blog manager. And one of the best things that you can do with Wix is this part over here. You see where it says enroll in this free course and it has this image? I just added that myself. No need to find a different widget, no need to customize CSS or any particular line of code. All I did was click on add, put an image, I selected an image from my image library. Say, let me add another image. Let's say it's this one. And I put add to page. And there it is. So what all I did, I just resized it to fit over there, dragged it all the way over there. Say that's what I'm just doing right now. And bam. So if you want to add a fun little widget here to link to your affiliate posts or anything that you have affiliate links in, if you want them to enroll in your free course or latest webinar, you can do this from the sidebar, which is 100% customizable. Maybe your categories, instead of having this thing that's fed in, you just want to have different icons where the person or site's visitor can click and go directly to a category. So you can customize this sidebar 100% the way that you like. Or you can also add Wix's elements that it feeds automatically. So recent posts, I don't even need to click on this. It does this automatically. So if I want to add something to my sidebar, what do? I just click on add, go all the way down to blog, and you'll see here the blog elements. I can add recent posts, featured posts, an archive, categories, tag cloud, RSS button, a custom feed, ticker, post gallery, related posts, post lists, Facebook comments, Discus comments, and also I can add related apps from the Wix market. So say I want to add this RSS button and I want to add this one over here. So I just clicked on it. You'll see that will feed in into this section. Say I just want to put it over here, right next to recent posts. Just drag and drop and bam, I am good to go. It's there on my website. I have absolutely no limitations as to where I can add any single elements. And that is it, you guys. I hope that you enjoyed this video and that you now understand why having a blog on Wix is absolutely awesome, and you can make any change on any feature that you so desire. Just remember that whenever you're doing a new change, you have to click save and publish to make the changes live. I'll see you guys in the next video.